Staying alive. Here we are. We're back again.
And it's Friday.
It's Friday. So we're excited to have you here, and we've got an exciting show planned today. Some of the things we're going to do, we have Mike and Holly that are jumping out of an airplane.
Skydiving. Oh, I wish I could have done that with them.
You can.
I've always wanted to do that.
Really?
Uh-huh.
We'll get you up there.
It's thrilling.
And we have Blanca. We have her famous cheesecake. We did like four recipes last week. This was Mike, my favorite. So she's going to come on today. It's a tape segment, and we're going to show you, and then we'll list the ingredients so people at home will be able to make the cheesecake.
And it was delicious.
It was.
It was so
awesome.
Good. I can see why it's your favorite.
And then Dr. Lockhart is going to talk about the worth of a soul. We'd kind of like to lay the foundation for our TV show. It's the same foundation for our book. Again, she was my favorite professor at BYU, and the reason why was because she combined the physical education with the spiritual aspect. So that's what I love so much about Dr. Lockhart, and why I've invited her here to be with me is just I really appreciate, you know, how she combines those. And most of the other teachers that I had, they didn't do that, and that's why I loved your classes so much.
So are you going to say this every show?
Well, I feel like it's like, I don't know.
That's good.
Anyway, maybe I shouldn't talk so much about it. But
embarrass me.
And then coming up, also we're going to talk a little bit about the website, so we're going to get you guys familiar with kind of how to maneuver around our website, so you can feel comfortable with that and know how to order things that you're interested in
and
stuff.
And Karen's going to sing today for us?
She is.
Yeah. Oh, she's a beautiful voice.
Yeah, you didn't hear her voice last week, but you had a chance to hear it during the taping.
Uh-huh.
So
it was so good.
And also next week, we're excited to have some healthy chocolate. We've got some representatives from this company coming in that for all you women, anybody out there like chocolate? Anyway, we're going to have a representative from the company that's going to talk about the healthy chocolate that's kind of a craze right now here in Utah and I guess some surrounding states. So
sounds good.
Anyway, so I guess we're going to go now. We'd like to roll to Mike and Holly's video, and then we'll make a few comments about that. So I think you guys want
now, now did Mike do the photography on this?
Mike did the photography. He has a camera on the top of his head. So it's pretty cool.
So we got to know him last week, Mike and Holly. We got to know them as we interviewed them. They're our fitness experts. And today we're going to see them just enjoying life, doing a physically active skydiving, which you can do when you're fit.
Now, this was Holly's first time, so she's actually on top of another guy. And Mike...
Oh, a tandem?
Yeah, a tandem. And then Mike goes out before... so he can take the picture of him.
Okay.
So anyway, we're excited to roll to that segment. So let's go ahead and roll that, Micah.
All right, Holly. What are we doing here today?
Finally jumping out of the plane.
In the night over 2 years.
Low 14. This is a 20-minute call. Low 14, 20 minutes.
Anything you want to say to your family? Since your family home?
Finally doing it. Let's go. I'm ready.
All right. See you guys at the plane.
showing no surprise. Yeah. We're living on the edge.
Your mom and dad?
Come out and do it.
All right, thanks.
Aren't they darling? How long have they been married, Tom?
Like 2 years.
2 years. They're so cute. It's gonna be so much fun to have them on the show.
Well, it's just, you know, when you're healthy, it's like you can do those kind of things, you know. And it's like when you don't push yourself to the point where you get injured. And you know, it's like so many people, they're fit for a little while and during their life, and then the rest of their life, they're struggling with all the injuries because, you know, they push themselves too hard. So it's like, I think Mike and Holly have kind of found a good balance.
Yeah, that's good. They sure are having fun.
So anyway, you keep saying you want to get up there.
Oh,
we've got to get you
I've
up there.
I've always wanted to do that.
So yeah. We'd like to lead into Dr. Lockhart's segment here. Now, one of the things you've talked a lot about is the worth of a soul. And what kind of things kind of brought you to that in your life? And can you just kind of give us a little bit of background and then talk about how you feel about it?
And why it's so important? Because what we're trying to do with our show is teach healthy principles. And then you learn these healthy principles and then your own life is happy and healthy because of it's based on true principles. Well, one of the basic ones is what we call the worth of the soul. And of course, soul is body and spirit. So whenever we refer to soul, it's the whole person. And oftentimes people leave out the body. Can you imagine that if you're thinking of the whole person and not even including the body?
When we talk about it, we have our, you know, our logo, it's like one side is the fitness and the nutrition, the other side is the mind and the spirit, and together those two entities make up the soul.
Right.
And so, you know, a lot of people, they talk a lot about the body, but they ignore the mind and the spirit, and a lot of people talk about the mind and the spirit, but they ignore the body.
So we're dealing with the whole person, the soul. Now, worth, you ask about my own experience back 100 years ago. I was in the Olympics in speed skating.
10 years ago, right?
10 years ago. And my thought was, I had to somehow earn my value or my worth. And that problem hasn't gone away. I think it's almost worse. I think it's almost escalated in this day and age. Philosophers and clergy call this a day of metaphysical hunger. We're yearning and we're confused. We're yearning to know the purpose of life and to have a sense of what is real. And back when you think back, oh, maybe 50, 80 years ago, America was basically rural. People lived on farms, families stayed together. Everyone was needed. The children were needed to raise the crops. And there wasn't this sense of not knowing who we are, not having a sense of purpose. But in today's age, where there's so many families that are broken up, and so many children, I think, are being raised with an idea of who am I and what is my purpose and what is my reality and my worth or my value. And so it's so important to realize that worth or our value isn't in our hands. And what happened with me
not
was... It's not something we earn. It's not even something we can come up with anyway. It's inherent or intrinsic, or it comes with us. It's part of our being. And what happened with me with the skating was I thought that I had to do something outstanding or achieve this outstanding accomplishment to be of value, and particularly to be of value to my parents. Now, I have wonderful, wonderful parents. They've died years and years ago, but just wonderful parents. You couldn't ask for a better mother and father than I had. But somehow I got the idea that to please them or to be acceptable to them, I had to achieve. Now, some people do that with weight, with appearance, with money, with other kinds of accomplishments, a job. Or
I think I did that when I was younger because I was involved in sports, and I think they call it self-esteem. You like to call it, you know, individual worth is a better term and a better way to look at things. But it's like, I think my self-esteem was kind of tied to how well I did on the athletic field. If I did good that day and beat other people, then I felt good about myself. And if I lost, then I felt bad about myself.
Okay, that's it exactly. And that's why this is such a crucial principle to teach right up front in terms of our show. Because the tendency is going to be for people to get fit so they can feel good about themselves. But the principle is to dig deep down inside. Prayer is the key. To trust in a higher power, to trust in God, to know that your worth is great to Him. Then you base your own self-esteem, if you will, your own good sense of self, on the fact that you're loved by God. And then it's not the circumstances. It's not how much you weigh. It's not how much you earn. It's not any of these worldly factors that make up your perception of self or your worth. It's inherent, it's infinite, it's eternal. A wonderful way to understand this is this beautiful picture by Carl Bloch, and it's the Pool of Bethesda.
When was this drawn?
Oh, it was in the late 1800s. It was one of his last paintings. And it depicts a man who was at the Pool of Bethesda. Now, the pool was significant because if somebody helped you get into the pool, or you were able to get into the pool, then it had this healing effect. It was healing waters. That's what people believed. Now, this man was infirm, the scriptures say, in John 5 in the New Testament, so he couldn't get into the pool. But look at this as an example of what we're talking about, the worth of the soul. Now, here's a man who is incapacitated. He can't even get that little distance to get into the
pool.
For
how long? He was
the scripture says 38 years he was infirmed. Now, he couldn't even make that little distance on his own. Obviously, he can't work. You wouldn't look on him and say, now there's a particular beauty about him. So any of these factors that we normally think of for good self-esteem, none. This man has none. And so the Savior comes to him, and he has to lift his blanket. The man can't even approach the Savior. The Savior has to lift his blanket, and he poses the question, wilt thou be made whole? And the man said, I have no way to get into the water. And then the Savior said, rise, take up thy bed and walk. And he was healed. What's beautiful about this is to realize he was every bit as much worth to the Savior as every other person. And that's the way we are. Every one of us is of infinite worth. We're of great worth. And it's not dependent on what we do. It's just because of who we are. We're children of God, and he loves us dearly.
And we talk about that a lot in our book.
Yes.
You know, and we talk about, you know, our capacity as children of our Heavenly Father, and basically, you know, our potential is limitless. Recently we were kind of editing a little bit of our book, and we were talking about our minds and our capacities, mm-hmm. and how we only use 10 to 15%. And it's like, you know, it's like the average person uses maybe 10%. It's like Albert Einstein, I think they said, used 15%. I mean, where would we be if we used 100%? I mean, what would we be able to do? And so it's just with the mind alone, we get a little bit of feel for what our potential is like, you know, if we're at full capacity. I don't think the Lord would bless us with this great capacity and then not give us the opportunity to fully develop it.
That's right. And here, this is from Dr. Belknap, Dean Belknap. He says, through the joint effort of body, brain, and mind, we become the living results of our own thoughts. Every action we take of any kind is affected by prior programming, imprinting. So this is what we're talking about. If we have a positive attitude toward ourselves based on an eternal truth that our worth is infinite, it's eternal, then that affects our whole being. I love from Dr. Chopra, who said, when we're happy, we make trillions of cells happy. Don't you love that image?
Mm-hmm.
Of all our cells dancing and happy when we're happy with ourselves.
People, I think they separate the mind and the body and the spirit, and they don't realize that it functions as a whole.
As a complete wholeness. And then your happiness isn't based on, as you said, hitting a home run or doing well in baseball, but it's because you know your worth is great. And what it does is it allows you to differentiate or separate who you are from your behavior. And so you can look on somebody and know the worth of every soul is great, even if they aren't treating you very well. And you can sort out the person from the behavior. And that way, we do the same thing with ourselves. I'm always of great value. I'm always precious. And even if I do things that aren't up to my standard or disappoint, it doesn't make me get down on myself.
And you said you struggled with this when you were a speed skater.
I did.
I mean, she was like the best in the world, and you're struggling with your self-esteem. It's like, how does that happen?
Isn't it interesting? We tend to see people on television or movie stars or athletes, and we think, wow, they've got it all together. They're the happiest people around, but oftentimes they're not. Oftentimes inside, the feeling I had was, if you really knew me, you wouldn't like me, because I didn't like me. Isn't that sad? And I had this great way of protecting so that you wouldn't get to know me. And what happened was, the more I accomplished, I expected it to change. And I thought, well, somewhere I'm going to start liking myself. I'm going to start feeling good about myself, but it didn't happen. And so finally I just got on my knees one day and I prayed and said, Heavenly Father, do you love me? And the answer was so powerful. Well, of course I love you. You're my daughter. And then I knew that I was of infinite worth to him, precious to him. And then I stopped basing a good sense of self on these things of the world.
Did it change all of a sudden, or was it gradual?
Well, I was really fortunate because I knew right away that he loved me. What was interesting, then it took some time because I had so programmed these negative thoughts. I put myself down terribly. And so it took almost another half of a year of praying and saying, I want to feel good about myself. I want to feel precious the way I know that Heavenly Father, the way you feel about me. And one day he changed my heart. And it was from that point on, I never went back.
So you stopped that negative talk.
I stopped the negative talk. And I really believe deep down inside that I'm precious to Heavenly Father and to the Savior. And when you know that, what more do you need? And I stopped putting so much weight on what other people think, or if I have a good day or not, or successful or not, and was able to then separate the good sense of self, the worth, from my behavior.
Now, I know a lot of people in the audience probably struggle with their weight. How would you relate this to weight loss?
Well, that's why this is so important. Come to a sense of you are precious just as you are right now, body and spirit, just as you are. Then, when you realize how sacred your whole self is, that's your motivation then to say, well, I want to do better. I want to look a little better. And so your worth isn't dependent on losing the weight. Your worth is already there. You're already precious. And then that motivates you to do well. So if you lose weight or not, it doesn't affect your good sense of self.
It's kind of you're more internally motivated instead of externally
That's
motivated.
That's right. You're totally internally motivated instead of externally. And it's so powerful. It's actually much more powerful and more lasting than extrinsic motivation. It's a very, very powerful truth.
Well, I mean, I think this is the key to being happy. Don't you believe that? If we really understand our worth as individuals, as children of our Heavenly Father, and then all those things that we always put in our past, like, I don't know if I can do this or not, and all these blocks, I think, are kind of opened up, so we don't place all those blocks in our paths of being all that we can be.
And you establish reality. You can choose what you perceive as real. And so your reality becomes that worth that's eternal. And do you know, it's in no one's hands. It's not in your hands. It's not at anyone else's. So you can't affect it. You can't increase your worth. You can't decrease your worth. And no one else can either. And so the beauty is it makes you so secure personally. People say to me, are you ever unhappy? Do you ever have a bad day? And I hardly ever do. Of course I can be unhappy and get hurt and all those things, but it doesn't last long because that's not my reality. You want to feel all the emotions. You don't want to stuff your emotions. And so, of course, you're responsive to the things that happen in life. But you don't take your reality from those things. You always draw from your higher power.
Mm-hmm. I remember the saying that they say God's only sorrow is for the sins of the world. You know, he doesn't feel any other sorrow for any, you know, his feelings of worth are perfect, you know. And it's like, I think that's what you're talking about. I mean, he's the perfect example. Christ was a perfect example of that.
And his perfect love for us. Nothing can alter that. Not anything we do. I mean, the real key to understanding this is the atonement of the Savior. That God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And Christ atoned for us. He gave his life for each of us. Now, we have to realize how precious we are when we take that to heart. That it wasn't just for mankind in general, but each one of us personally.
Well, we appreciate you sharing your experience. I know that this has been a lifelong pursuit for you.
It has, and it's one of my favorite things to teach. My real yearning is for every single person, every individual to know his or her worth is great. For each person to know that she or he is precious.
And we don't mean to, you know, beat on our chest about our book, but it's like we feel like we've taught some of those basic principles in our book and tried to do it in a balanced way where people, if they really internalize those principles, you know, they will. I think they will really understand how precious they are.
And if reading about it or hearing about it motivates a person to get on their knees and pray about it, that's the key. That's the real key.
It's that relationship. Well, thank you, Dr. Lockhart. Isn't she a sweetheart? we were driving from the show the other day, and she was following me, and I think I pulled off to get something to eat, and you had to get down to Provo or something anyway. She kept going, and then all of a sudden I saw this big puff of smoke, and I was worried about her.
It was huge. It was black smoke all through the whole sky.
So I called her, and she didn't answer, and it's like I kept thinking, was that Dr. Lockhart that got in this accident? And anyway, I went to Super Salad to eat, a really healthy place that I like. And I called her, and she didn't call, but she finally called me. But I was thinking the whole time, it's like, I didn't tell her that I loved her, you know? And it's like, I wanted to tell her that, you know? And it's like, so anyway, I told her that later. But I just appreciate, you know, that, because I think it's so important for people.
It
I
is.
Think that's the most important thing that we can teach as a show and as a company, is the worth of a soul.
So that basically underlies everything we do.
So
thanks, Tom.
We'd like to go, this is, we're going to roll to Blanca's segment on cheesecake. And this is my favorite recipe. I've said it before, but it's like, I know Karen was asking me, she's like, I want some more of that cheesecake. She says, all my friends are asking
so
about
good.
It. So it's like, I think Blog is going to be famous just with this one recipe. So let's roll to Blanca and her cheesecake, and we'll be right back.
Now, Blanca, I'm only seeing raw ingredients. Dates,
walnuts,
cashews, lemon, and the nectar.
So what are you concocting for us, Blanca?
She's going to make out of this a cheesecake.
Cheesecake,
okay,
that's right.
Let's see.
So why is it called a cheesecake?
Well, it's called cheesecake because it tastes like cheesecake.
It tastes like cheesecake.
I never taste real cheesecake, but people usually say that it tastes like cheesecake.
So that's why it's cheesecake.
Yes. And it's very, very easy to make, and it takes maybe 10 minutes.
10 minutes. Okay.
So what do we need? We need a blender, food processor. We need cashew, cup and half of cashew, and important thing is that we need to soak the cashew overnight. Then
wait, you need to what?
Soak it.
Soak it.
In
why
the
do you
water.
Why? Why is that?
Because it's very hard to digest without soaking, and when nuts are soaked in the water, they release the enzymes which are important for digestion. So that's why we want to soak them. I mean, if you wanted to rush and make cheesecake really fast, you can do that, but I don't guarantee that people are not going to complain for their tummy
stomach.
Pain. Yes,
uh-huh.
Because it's very hard to digest. So then we have walnuts. So we soaked 1 cup of walnuts overnight, and dates. You don't need to soak the dates. So for the crust, and again, we need 1 plate, which is made to be put in the freezer because we are going to freeze overnight the cheesecake. So for the crust, we need 1 cup of the walnuts, 1 cup of dates, and we put them in the food processor and blend them together. And so we put the crust on the top of our dish.
Now, let me ask you this. You put the dates and the walnuts. Does it come to a mushy consistency?
No, it's not mushy. It's more like grinding and sticking together because dates, they can kind of attach to the walnuts.
So you want it to be a little crunchy.
Yes, a little crunchy. You don't want to be mushy.
Okay.
And then filling is made from cashew. So you put the cashew, 1.5 cup of cashew in the blender. Then you put 1/2 cup of water and 2 squeezed lemons. So you have maybe 1/4 cup or 1/2 cup of lemon juice. And then you use the honey or my famous aqua nectar, which I really like. And so about like 1/2 cup.
Mm-hmm.
If you like very, very sweet and you have sweet tooth, so you can use 1 cup.
Okay.
So, and we blend this all together, and you just need to be careful so you don't want it too watery or too really thick. So you just need to kind of see how it looks in the blender.
So you're going to blend that right now, or?
No, I'm not going to blend it right now because I already made the cheesecake.
You already made it.
I made it last night for you guys.
And how long does it take?
Well, I made it like 8 o'clock in the evening. And.
But how long does it take to
but
make?
About 10 minutes to
about
make.
About 10 minutes
and
to
then
make.
10
minutes.
Freeze overnight.
And freeze overnight. Okay. And cheesecake looks like this. It's very tasty.
And now we
so
get to taste again.
Now you get to taste it again, so I can cut it for you. So everyone can get a little piece.
So this is the one that you're famous for, right?
Yes, it's a famous cheesecake.
Blanca's famous cheesecake.
Now it tastes really, really good.
Is this the one all the neighborhood runs to when she comes to the neighborhood party?
Yeah.
The thing is that you can be creative and you can put on top of the cheesecake like blueberries or cherries or whatever you like. Uh-huh. So it kind of make it interesting and tastes better. So where's your plate, Barbara? I'll try not to break it because we left it here and it's a little bit
So how long do you freeze it for, Blanca?
Overnight. You freeze it overnight.
Tom?
And you might have a cup of coffee with it.
Cup of what?
Coffee.
Coffee? I don't drink coffee.
I'm just joking.
Cup of juice, maybe.
Well, a cup of juice, carrot juice, maybe. So.
I don't want to go first here.
So you want to see the Barbara's reaction first?
No, I just want to,
okay,
you know.
I'll be the guinea pig.
It tastes like cheesecake?
It really does.
So now Tom.
I like it better than cheesecake.
That's what people say. That's what she says. That people like it better than cheesecake.
I like it better than cheesecake.
So while you're eating, I just repeat the ingredients. So you need, for the crust, 1 cup of walnuts, 1 cup of dates. You soak overnight the walnuts, so that's for the crust. Then for the filling, you need 1.5 cup of cashew, which you soak, and lemon juice, like 1/4 cup of lemon juice, 1 cup of honey or aqua nectar, and you just blend it together, pour on top of the crust, and put the freezer overnight.
Now, real cheesecake has like doesn't have like over 100 grams of fat in it.
Maybe more, I don't know.
But this, I know that there's some protein, you know, and there's some fat, but it's the healthy kind of fat.
Yes, the nuts are really high in fat, so you should eat them sparingly. Mm-hmm. So not every single day as ice cream.
Right.
But our ice cream, but yeah, it's a really good choice to eat this kind of cheesecake.
Cool. Thank you, Blanca.
You're welcome.
This is delicious. Well, I was tanking on that.
Yeah, you weren't talking very much.
No.
You were eating.
It was so good.
You guys need to make that, seriously.
It was so good.
So we hope we left that the recipe up there long enough so people can write it down. Because you were saying that's why you get frustrated so many times.
Well, you watch a cooking show and they're so fast, for me anyway, I'm trying to write down. So
we also met with a company, and I think they're going to build a kitchen for us. So we're going to actually have our own kitchen here on the show.
Oh, that'd be fun.
So I called Blanca, and she was like so excited about it.
I bet she was excited.
And then we're also going to have, I think we're going to hold cooking shows. They have this amazing facility where they have, it's top-of-the-line appliances, mm-hmm. and they actually said we can film over there. I don't know if we can go over there and film or not, but we can actually teach classes. So we're going to be offering healthy living classes. And the owner of the place, he said, I think there's a real need out there because it's like most people, and that's why we have Blanca on. Again, she's so healthy that, you know, it's like most people can't relate to her because they've never been exposed to that before. But it's like, you know, I think sometimes it takes somebody like that to be able to cause kind of a revolution and to kind of catch people's interest because we all know how to cook the normal stuff. You know, most people have some really good recipes because it's been handed down through their families, but these type of recipes that she's coming up with, most people are not familiar with.
They're really unusual. And today is such a fast food day, we just hardly ever take time. Even just to sit down together for dinner, it'd be nice if we could just do that much.
So everything, all those ingredients, they're all no chemicals. None of them are cooked, so they're all raw, and it's only healthy stuff. So.
And it's a dessert.
And it's a dessert. We're going to actually have her cook some, you know, main dishes too, but, you know, We wanted to start
with the good stuff.
Start with the
fun
stuff.
I love to eat my dessert first.
So now what we'd like to do is we'd like to roll. We're going to take you through our website so you guys can get familiar. I keep saying you guys. See you folks. So you can get familiar with our website. And we're excited about, you know, any things that you really like on our show, you can go to our website. That's the address right there. But we'd like to roll to that tape, and I'll run you through the website. Okay, this is our main website. It's gotgaga.com. We're clicking there. This is to order our book. And basically, you go down there and you type in your name, email address, your phone number, a phone where we can contact you, and then where you're located. A lot of you are outside of Utah. And then just push send, and that email comes to me, and I will send that, give you a call, and send you a copy of our book. Now, to go up to products, this is our back office for all our products. We have a couple hundred products on there. Now, if we wanted to go down to, I think we have here, what are we starting with? I think these are our essential oils. We actually, Karen has about 250 essential oils, and we're just in the process of getting all those up right now, but they will be up here in the next week. And so our essentials oils, those will all be up. And then also Karen, we're going to have her CDs are going to be here under music. And so that will be up. These are our nutritionals. We've chosen nutritionals that don't have some of the bad ingredients are no longer involved, but a lot of the nutritionals have caffeine. None of our nutritionals have that. This is probably our main product that we promote. We'll be talking about our four today. We have jams there. We have Spry, which is the sweetened with xylitol, which is a natural sweetener. It has very, very low on the glycemic index, all natural ingredients. It's made out of bark and corn. Then we're going back here, going to some of our other products. Let's see. All these, they're divided by sections. This is our skincare line. It's created from Janelle Henderson. Some more clear products. We will have her on as a guest. Her father was world famous. He developed in the 50s. He made penicillin bioavailable, and he also worked with burn clinics. Here are polar heart monitors. We have the balls, the cords, the cushions, you know, all things for fitness. We have, you know, a lot of different fitness products there. It's just taking us some time to enter all of Karen's products because she has, like, you know, 250 oils on there, and she has 30 different CDs, and so she has a lot of stuff there. So we're excited to get her products on our website. We're also getting our healthy chocolate. We're working on that. So we're going to get our healthy chocolate, but it'll be there under nutritionals will be the healthy chocolate. We're going down here. We're clicking on our coaching. Like, if you'd like to hire Karen as your massage therapist or Holly or Mike as your personal trainer, then you just go here, type in your information there, and then it says the type of coach that you're interested in. And you just type in, you know, Karen Grant or Holly Siminoff that you'd like, you know, to have as your personal coach. So that's our coaching button. We also have a clothing line. It's kind of centered around athletic apparel right now. And we're expanding the line. We're getting more things. But these are some of the fun, you know, we have all different kinds of things, T-shirts, women's shirts, caps, you know, all different kinds of stuff. So if you want to order on some of our clothing, you just click on products, and that takes you through, you know, some of our clothing. And so, again, we're getting a hold of some really, really good stuff. And then, that goes into the other stuff, but that's our clothing line. And then I think we're going to go up here, and we're going to actually go to our singles site. This is for healthy-minded singles. So if you're single out there, I'm sure there's quite a few singles, right? Dr. Lockhart and I are both single, so I'm on there. She's not on there yet. Maybe we could talk her into it. I don't know. But anyway, this is for healthy-minded singles. So if you're healthy-minded, you need to get on our single site. So I think there's about 500 people right now on our site. We've had it up for just a few months. So We're getting more and more people each day, but it's free to be on there. There's no charge. We're going here to our fitness site, and it just gets a little pop-up, and then we expand it here. We actually sell websites to personal trainers and gym owners. That's one of the things we do. Those are some of our nutritional products. One of the things that I really like the most is our energizing emails. People need daily reminders, don't you think, Dr. Lockhart?
It helps. It certainly helps.
And these, we've created these. We have about 400, I think about 500 actually. And you just go down there. If you're interested just in the body, or if you're interested in the mind and the spirit, you click on all three. Some people are just interested in one or two of those. Type in your email address, put your name, you know, address, or just your phone number, and then click if you want it every day or once a week, and then just click sign up. And then that will, every single day you will get, you know, if you sign up for the daily energizing emails. I just think I get so many positive comments about our energizing emails.
So maybe one would be how precious each one of us is, the
right.
Worth of the soul.
Yeah, that would be like a spirit.
Uh-huh.
You know, and then we'd have something about maybe nutrition, or we'd have something about fitness. But it's just a great daily reminder of things that, you know, we can do to
great
be
idea.
More healthy.
Great idea.
And this is our online, we're actually going to our recipes here. There's over 100,000 actually now. We were at 90,000. Now there's over 100,000 recipes. And I typed low fat in here the first time, and I'm not sure why it didn't work, because it usually works. I don't know what was going on. We were recording this earlier, and I can't see what it's saying there. But then I went back and I typed in, like, you can type in basically whatever you want if you want. I think maybe because I typed in low carb or low fat. I can't remember what I did. But then I typed in raw food, and I think it pulled up about 200 different recipes for raw. And then what you do is if you're interested in appetizers or desserts, here we're going back to desserts again.
Or maybe you just put in protein or...
Yeah, you can put in high protein or high, you know, you can put in whatever you want. But it goes down there, and then you find a recipe that you're interested in, you click on it, and it tells you, it pulls up exactly, it has a picture of the dish when it's done, and then it has also how to make the dish. It tells you step by step, this is what you do, this is what you do, this is what you put in it. And
the components.
And the components. And then off on the right there, it tells you exactly like your fats. Right there, it has your fats, proteins, carbohydrates, saturated fats. You know, so it's just a great recipe.
Resource.
Yeah, a great
now,
resource.
All this is on GAGA. You stayed on the same website.
Right, yeah. It's all linked to gotgaga.com. So you can get everything that you've seen here, you can get to through gotgaga.com. And so we're trying to make it, again, we have about $2 million worth of technology on this website. We hope you like it. We hope you appreciate it. If you have any comments like you'd like to write myself or Dr. Lockhart, you can call us at that one number. It's 1-888-750-GAGA. Or you can just click there on the email address and it'll pull up, or you can email us. We'd love to hear your comments. If you have some things that you'd like to see on the show to make the show more interesting, again, this show is for you. It's to help you be more healthy in your life, body, mind, and spirit. I mean, that's the goal of the show. That's the goal of the company. So we'd love to hear your comments. If you have anything that you'd like to, you know, tell us, we'd love to have you, you know, get into our book and read maybe, you know, some more things about the book. And then, you know, email us back and tell us what you think. And if there's some things that you think we can do better or, you know, make improvements, we're open to that.
That's a fabulous website. How long did it take you to develop that?
We've been working on it. Paul Ward is the main, our IT guy, and he's the main person that's been working on it. But we've put a lot of work into it.
A lot of work into that. It's tremendous. Look at how many alternatives you have and all the possibilities just on the one website.
Right. And we actually have a couple other websites. We have a talent website.
Uh-huh.
But we've kept that separate because our talent is mostly right here in Utah. But our gotgaga.com is nationwide and worldwide. So we didn't want to throw something on our main site that
mm-hmm.
is just Utah.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to appeal to everyone because we know that there's a lot of people from other states out there right now. I mean, this show is broadcast in Wyoming and Nevada and parts of Oregon and parts of Idaho. So it's like, it's not just a Utah, you know, publication. And so that's what we're trying to do with our website. We're trying to give people, you know, from all over the nation opportunity to use and see what we're doing. So
it's tremendous.
So what we'd like to go to next, we have Karen singing, actually.
Now, Karen Grant came, and we interviewed her last week, and she's the one that has the line of essential oils, and then she's put together her songs and made up CDs to go with these oils. And then she, of course, does a massage, and she particularly focuses on families. I love that aspect of it. Mm-hmm. And she did a little massage with you and with me me last week. It was
you were laying down
it
on the job.
Wonderful. I didn't want that one to stop. We said we'll give you all day to stop this.
We're going to actually air that a little bit later because it was cranial sacral.
In several weeks.
Yeah. And so that focuses more on the head, massaging the head, mm-hmm. and that kind of thing. And
but
then,
today we get to hear her sing.
Today we get to hear her sing.
She has a beautiful voice.
So
beautiful.
We'd like to roll to that segment. This is Karen Grant, and she's going to be singing. One of the things that I love about her songs is they're all dedicated to the Savior. She mm-hmm. said she made the commitment to the Savior earlier in mm-hmm. her life.
Mm-hmm. And you can feel that.
Yeah. So let's roll to Karen. Welcome, everybody. We are excited to have Karen on. She's going to actually sing a song for us. And can you tell us a little bit about the song that you're going to sing for us?
Sure. This song is called Sense of Peace, and it goes with an oil for the musical and aromatherapy duets that I do for my clients. And so all the music that I've written goes with massage and nurturing the spirit. So that's
any particular story behind this one?
This one, I had a client who was pregnant, and her husband was away, and she was very afraid to go through her birth, labor, and delivery on her own. And so this song was written for her. And then I ended up using, you know, I'd sing it to her in her little massages with just instrumental background, kind of lullaby the client on the table type of thing. And then put it on CD and ended up using it on the CD called The Healer's Touch with 9 oils for nurturing the spirit.
So even though you did this for the one person, it has general applicability.
Well, we all need ministering angels, and we're all going through something that we need divine assistance with. So this is to comfort, soothe, and bless.
This is The Healer's Touch.
The Healer's Touch CD, and the song is called Sense of Peace.
Sense of Peace.
Thank you.
Touch on your brow, angels comfort you now, bringing heart and mind sweet release. A stroke, a caress, angel hand soothe and bless your soul with a sense of peace. Oh, know ye not, angels near, coming to comfort you, soothe and cheer. I pray an angel's soft caress will touch your soul with happiness. Sweet refreshed heart and mind gently blessed, without a care in world. Your burdens are lifting with peace, angels gifting your cares, soar with them heavenward. Oh, know ye not, angels walk near, coming to comfort you, soothe and cheer. I pray soul with happiness. sweet refreshed heart and mind gently blessed without a care in this world. Your burdens are lifting, his peace angels gifting, your cares soar with them heavenward. Oh, know ye not, angels are near, coming to comfort you, soothe and cheer. I pray an angel soft come rest, will touch your soul with happiness. Oh, know ye not, the Savior is near, his love.
Doesn't she have a beautiful voice?
It's so soothing. Oh, and beautiful.
I just think that we talk a lot about in our book the importance of our thoughts. And don't you think that it's just a wonderful way to influence your life for the positive or for the better, to have good music?
No question. And the power of thoughts, I think, way beyond what we mostly give it credit, how much our thoughts dictate our happiness and our well-being. And music, oh, there's such power in music. And that's why we're so concerned that our children listen to good music. But just think of how soothing that is. And that is a sense of peace. You feel it. It's a tangible feeling when you hear music like that. She has such a beautiful voice. Mm-hmm. We're really fortunate to have her.
We are. She has so much energy. She's getting us all these guests. We're just excited to have Karen on. She's actually the one that lined up the chocolate.
Oh, good. I can't wait to taste the healthy.
Yeah.
We do get to taste that, don't we?
We do.
Okay, good.
Yeah, we'll get to taste that next week. So,
Well, you look at someone like Karen now. She's told us that she actually lost over 100 pounds. She told us about a tough time of going through a divorce. And yet, look at her. She has not let those hardships define her. And so again, as we talk about the worth of the soul, if you really dig deep down inside and you trust in the Lord to know that worth, rather than letting the challenges of life and the circumstances of life define you, but let our Creator define you. That's what she's done. You can see it in her countenance.
Oh, yeah.
She's a happy soul.
And when she's on the set, it's like she's going around to all the people and lifting their spirit.
Yeah,
it's like
she's a healer. Yeah, she can't help but heal and reach out to people. It's had such an impact in her own life. So you can feel the same with you and I.
One of the things we're excited about tonight, actually, from 7 to 9, we announced it last week, but it's going to be at the Quality Inn. And I'm going to actually get people down on the floor doing push-ups and sit-ups.
Oh, good for you.
So,
make us work.
That's right. So Dr. Lockhart will talk. Maybe you were able to see this part of the show, but you'd like your spouse to see, you know, hear more about the worth of a soul or whatever. We're going to actually have that opportunity tonight from 7 to 9 at the Quality Inn.
At American Fork?
In American Fork. And it's going to be a 4-week conference, so we're going to start this Friday and every succeeding Friday for the next 4 weeks. And if you bring a companion, the companion gets in for half price. It's $10 a night, but they get in for $5 if you bring somebody with you.
We're really expensive, aren't we? You
Not
were saying
really.
On the website you could have a personal trainer for $15 a month.
That's right.
Not a week, not a time,
well,
but a
well,
whole
if people,
month.
If people want to have the personal attention where a trainer actually comes out to their home, of course they're going to have to pay, you know, a lot more money than that.
Uh-huh.
But Thomas Monson said, if progress is measured and reported back, the rate of improvement or is measured, how does that go? Okay. you know that quote.
You do something, and then if you report back, your progress increases.
Right.
Substantially.
The rate of improvement accelerates, right. as he puts it. Right. So, you know, that's one of the things that we're really trying to do, is we're trying to give people, through our coaching program, a way to report back. And we've worked up these programs, these level 1 through level 5 programs for people, 1 day a week up to 6 days a week, and we've worked up the aerobic and the anaerobic, and we're going to start talking a lot more about the wave.
Oh, good.
I'm excited.
I'm excited to teach.
Dr. Lockhart's actually written a whole book about
mind-body fitness.
Mind-body fitness, but a lot of it you talk about the wave.
Right. It's a book that teaches you actually how to do this exercise program.
And so with the wave, basically what it is, maybe we can just kind of overview it just briefly. It's when you get your heart rate up, mm-hmm. and then you get it back down, and then you get it back up and then back down. Kind of what kicked off the aerobics craze in the 70s was the research saying that the best way to get fit was to get your heart rate up and hold it for a certain period of time and then let it drop. But a lot of the new research is saying, and that's why we'd like to be the ones that kind of kick this off across the country, right?
Well, the new guidelines, the national guidelines, now say rather than doing the steady state, accumulate 30 minutes of physical activity a day. And that moderate is actually better than the intense. And so the intense, the more steady state, the aerobic that we've taught for years and years, is more for people who want to train to be a competitive athlete. But for good health, moderate is better. And the wave, actually, we call it the wave because it's exercise and relaxation. Exercise and relaxation. It's dynamite.
So it actually, you actually not only learn how to get your body in shape, but you learn how to relax at the same time. Yeah.
You sleep better, you're less anxious.
And I've actually, when I learned this from Dr. Lockhart in college, I was in graduate school, I tested her theories out, and my resting heart rate was in the low 60s, and within 3 months, I was down in the low 50s. So I dropped my resting heart rate 10 beats a minute in the period of 3 months.
Wow.
Which is amazing. I mean, if your heart only has so many beats in it, I will actually live 14 years longer just because I incorporated the wave into my program. So, anyway.
You might live as old as I am.
You're just getting going.
Oh, here we go. Well, this has been such a fun show. The skydiving, wouldn't you just love to? Maybe we could go tandem. How about that?
Sure.
And with the cheesecake and Karen's beautiful song, and most of all, we really hope that you'll know how precious you are and the worth of your soul.
So we appreciate you tuning in. We love you, and we appreciate you, and we hope you'll be here next week.